Here, the user wants different numbers born from the same file, and first of all, he would like to know the viability of the cells. In other words, how many percent of the cells are inside this live gate, and how many, for example, here on the corner. So he has this R1 and the percent of this, and then he would like to know the amount of FITS positive cells, or GFP positive cells, in fact, and it's this gate, and he has also saved sample ID, which tells which kind of sample this was. And the traditional way of making this is to create stat list. You need three of them, and when I now jump forward files, then the stat list will collect the data for you. This is in theory it's good, but in practice, then when you need this data, you must copy and paste these all separately. So how to combine this collection of the data? So let's delete these stat lists like this and make it the other way around. Create collection tools and collector list. So when you created stat list, then you got the list of all available parameters that you can then visualize there, but collector lists list acts a little bit differently. You can connect only tokens into collector list. So first of all, you must create tokens from statistics. Those numbers that you want, you need a token for every number. For example, let's create token. Token was the object which holds only one statistical number. You can select only one, whereas in statlist you can select one or many. But the R1% of this was what we needed, and this H2, create token, H2% of this, and here create token and sample ID. And now those tokens can be connected to collector list like this. And now when we jump forward, you can see that this collector list combines the data from different data sources into one. One could ask that why we need these tokens between these statistics. Why don't we have the big list of all these possibilities from different statistics? But the fact is that that list would be enormously long if you have several statistics having maybe dozens of numbers. Then that list would be too long. That's why this system works via tokens. But this can be then copy-pasted into, for example, Excel, just like StatList.